Hi, in this chapter, we are going to see the building blocks for containers, specifically namespaces, control groups, and UnionFS. Namespace is a feature of Linux kernel which isolates and virtualizes system resources for a process so that each process gets its own resource, like its own IP address, hostname, etc. System resources which can be virtualized are mount, process ID, network, inter-process communication, hostname, users. Here is an example of PID namespace in which we have created a new namespace by virtualizing PID 5 of the host system. In the new namespace, we have process ID 1, 2, and 3, which corresponds to process ID 5, 6, and 7 of the host system respectively. For the new namespace, process ID 5 of the host system behaves as a root process. Now let us look at an example of network namespace in which we would create two namespaces on Linux system and then access one from another. For this, let us first create two network namespaces, NS1 and NS2. Now let us create a vEth pair device which would have two endpoints, tap1 and tap2. After that, we'll have the setup as shown on the screen. In the next step, we'll attach tap1 to NS1 namespace and tap2 to NS2 namespace. NS1 now would have a way to communicate with NS2 and vice versa. After enabling the link and giving the IP address to tap1 and tap2, we can start the packet transfer between NS1 and NS2 as we can see. Using the namespace feature of the kernel, we isolate one process from another. As container is nothing but a process for the kernel, we isolate each container using different namespaces. Another important feature which enables containerization is control groups. With control groups, we can limit account and isolate resource uses like CPU, memory, disk, network, etc. It is part of Linux kernel since 2007. We can list the control groups attached to a process from its /proc folder. Like here, we are listing for process ID 2202. Depending on the Linux kernel version, we would see different version and mount location for control groups. In our case, it is mounted under /sys/fs/cgroup. And we see different kind of available control groups. By default, a child process inherits the cgroup properties from its parent. The example we are going to look here is of freezer cgroup. With this cgroup, we can freeze a process or group of processes and then unfreeze them. Let us create a cgroup hierarchy called mygroup inside the freezer cgroup. We could see that some files have been automatically created inside my cgroup. The task file inside the hierarchy decides which processes are part of this particular cgroup. Now we are going to create a new bash shell and then get its process ID to attach to our cgroup. The new shell's PID is 3192, which we are going to put inside the tasks file. Now to freeze the process mentioned in the task file, we have to enable the frozen state to our cgroup, my cgroup. As soon as we freeze, our shell terminal with PID 3192 becomes unresponsive and whatever command we type will not be delivered to the shell. By sending thought state to our cgroup, we can release the process from frozen state. And as we can see, the commands which we typed while our shell was frozen are now delivered to the shell. Using control groups, we do resource allocation to each container like RAM, CPU, etc. Another important building block is UnionFS, by which we can transparently overlay two or more directories. We have a directory dir1 with files f1 and f2, and we have a directory dir2 with files f3 and f4. Once we create a single mount hierarchy using the overlay driver, we can see all the four files inside a single mount point union. UnionFS is used for implementing layered approach for containers. Think dir1 as one image which can be used as base image to start the container. They too can be thought as container-specific storage space. So in this chapter, we have learned about some of the building blocks for the containers. In the next chapter, we would see different container runtime, which would access these building blocks to create containers.